Hey everyone, we've all done it, right? You're planning a trip, so you Google the exchange rate. But what if I told you that number, the one you see on the screen, doesn't actually tell you the full story? Today, we're going to dig into the hidden layer that shows what your money is really worth.
I mean, think about it. You see that one US dollar equals, I don't know, maybe 100 Japanese yen. Simple enough. But does that really mean a $1 coffee here in the States costs the exact same as a 100 yen coffee in Tokyo? Well, not always. And that little gap, that difference, is exactly what we're going to unpack.
So it really comes down to two different ideas. First, you've got the nominal rate. That's the one we all know. It's the official number, the one you see on the screen. But then there's the other side of the coin, the real rate. And this is the one that truly matters, because it's about your actual real-world purchasing power. Okay, so how do we bridge that gap? How do we get from the simple number on our phone to what our money can actually do for us in another country? Turns out it's all in a pretty simple formula. Let's break down the pieces one by one.
First up is E. Now, this is our starting point. This is that nominal exchange rate we were just talking about, the standard face value number you'd find online or at any bank. Easy enough, right? Next, we need something called P star. This one sounds a little technical, but it's not. All it means is the price level in the foreign country. You can just think of it as a general average of how much stuff costs over there. This is a super important piece of the puzzle.
And the final piece is just P, no star this time. This is the exact same concept, but for us, right here at home. It's our domestic price level, basically the average cost of things in our own country.
So, now let's put it all together. The real exchange rate, which we call little e, is found by taking our familiar nominal rate, big E, and then adjusting it by the ratio of foreign prices to our home prices. This is the magic formula that uncovers the true purchasing power.
And this brings us to the absolute key takeaway. The whole game changes because of inflation. When the prices in your own country are rising faster than prices in the rest of the world, the real value of that exchange just gets, well, eaten away. It erodes.
Okay, that's the theory. But let's make this really concrete. We're going to jump back to 2010 and look at a real-world example to see exactly how this erosion actually works.
All right, check this out. Here's our scenario. Israel versus the U.S. back in 2010. The nominal rate, RE, was 4.65 Israeli shekels for every one U.S. dollar. But here's the kicker. U.S. inflation was only 2%, while Israel's was way up at 8%. That difference is everything.
So, before we can use our formula, we need to convert those inflation percentages into our price levels, P and P star. Let's imagine a starting price of 1 in each country. With 2% inflation in the U.S., the foreign price level, or P star, becomes 1.02. And with 8% inflation in Israel, the domestic price level, P, becomes 1.08. Okay, now we're ready to plug these in.
So we take our nominal rate, 4.65, and we multiply it by that ratio of price levels, 1.02 divided by 1.08. You can already see the number inside the parentheses is going to be less than 1. So what does that give us?
And there it is, 4.392. Whoa. Just look at that for a second. We started with a nominal rate of 4.65, but the real rate, the actual purchasing power, was all the way down at 4.392. That's a pretty big drop, and it tells a really important story.
And this just nails our main point. The real exchange rate eroded for one very clear reason. The domestic inflation in Israel was way higher than it was in the U.S. Those higher local prices just diluted the power of the dollars coming in. Simple as that.
Okay, so a number went down, but so what? Why should anyone care? What are the real consequences of this? Well, it turns out this has a massive, massive impact, especially if you're trying to run a business that sells things abroad.
See, this is a huge deal for a country's exporters. Think about an Israeli company selling its products in the U.S. for dollars. When the real exchange rate is high, they bring those dollars back home, convert them, and make a nice, healthy profit. But when that real rate erodes, like in our example, those same dollars now buy them fewer shekels in real terms. Their profits get squeezed, and suddenly they're less competitive on the world stage.
So let's just boil this all down. It's a clear chain reaction. It all starts with higher domestic inflation. That in turn causes the real exchange rate to erode. And the real world consequence? It directly hurts the profitability of that country's own exporters. It's a powerful and direct link.
So the next time you see an exchange rate flashing on a screen, you'll know there's a deeper story hiding just beneath the surface, a story about inflation and real purchasing power. It really makes you wonder, doesn't it? What other hidden economic forces are out there quietly shaping the value of everything all around us?